Armed with a wad of cash from selling PayPal, in October of 2001, Elon Musk traveled to Russia to buy three intercontinental ballistic missiles for $20 million. His ambitious and somewhat eccentric plan was to use these missiles to send a greenhouse to Mars and start growing plants. This was Musk's first foray into the world of space exploration, and it proved unsuccessful. The Russians declined to make a deal. Undeterred, Musk decided to go at it alone and create SpaceX. Fast forward to 2021, and SpaceX is developing the Starship vehicle, a fully reusable spacecraft capable of carrying up to 100 people to Mars. The Starship combined system is 120 meters tall and has a maximum payload to low Earth orbit of 100,000 kilograms, which is equivalent to 70 cars. That is significantly more than the space shuttle and the Falcon Heavy. The system is made up of several components. Starship, the spacecraft, will sit on top of a rocket called the Super Heavy. It also contains six efficient Raptor engines, oxygen and methane propellant tanks, and the payload compartment, sometimes called the upper stage, where people and cargo can be carried. But how close is Musk to making humanity into a genuinely spacefaring civilization? While 2020 was an unproductive year for most of us, the same can't be said for Elon Musk. After many years of hard work, SpaceX started testing Starship prototypes in January of 2020. Unfortunately, on February 28th, the second full-size prototype, called the SN1, was destroyed during a pressurized test. However, Musk didn't dwell on the untimely end of the SN1. Instead, he immediately got to work on SN2, and in a tweet, stated that each SN will have at least minor improvements, at least through SN20 or so of Starship V1.0. And that's exactly what's happening. After many more minor improvements, the SN15 successfully completed SpaceX's fifth high-altitude test in May of 2021. A few short months later, SpaceX is due to launch the SN20, predicted to be the first orbital version of the spacecraft. Or is it? Will SN20 be orbital or suborbital? Let's first clarify what orbital or suborbital means. Put simply, a suborbital spacecraft doesn't achieve the velocity to remain in orbit around the Earth and will naturally begin to fall back to the planet. So far, all Starship spacecraft have been suborbital, but will it be the same for the SN20? Like most things in science, the answer is somewhat complicated. Or, in other words, yes and no. The current evidence points to SN20 being capable of orbital flight, but stopping short of going into full orbit around the planet. Musk said he wants to see Starship reach orbit by the end of this year, and in May 2021, SpaceX filed a report with the Federal Communications Commission, FCC, to help make this happen. And what's more, we might see Starship in action sooner than you think. SpaceX's president, Gwynne Shotwell, said, "We're shooting for July." But will SN20 become truly orbital? Well, the FCC filing doesn't mention a deorbit burn, indicating that it will likely cut off its engines before achieving orbital status. It also states it will achieve orbit until performing a powered, targeted landing, approximately 100 kilometers, around 62 miles, off the northwest coast of Kauai in a soft ocean landing. Essentially, SpaceX wants to prove that Starship can achieve orbital status, since this is a vital stepping stone towards their end mission. However, they don't want to risk leaving their expensive machinery floating around in space. They'd rather learn how to actually land the rocket safely back on Earth, so that it can be used over and over again. According to the FCC flight plan, Starship will launch from Boca Chica, Texas, like the previous Starship tests. Once it reaches orbital altitude, The upper stage will orbit for a short time before splashing into the ocean near Hawaii, while the Super Heavy booster will land in the Gulf of Mexico. The SN20 will be a significant milestone in SpaceX's plan to create a self-sustaining city on Mars by 2050. But there's still much work to be done. The next items on the agenda will be to prove that the Heavy booster can repeatedly steer back to the launch pad using its grid fins, so it can be flown again, and proving Starship's refueling and space capabilities. Restocking fuel is a crucial part of SpaceX's space exploration goals, because without refilling Starship, it will only get into low Earth orbit, but not have the fuel to travel elsewhere. But if they can refill the tanks while in orbit, Starship can get all the way to Mars! Musk has stated in the past that transferring propellant is very simple, but we'll have to wait for future tests to see if his hunch is correct. Beyond a self-sustaining colony on Mars, Starship will also likely go to the moon. In 2020, SpaceX was awarded $135 million for adapting Starship's design so it could assist in NASA's Artemis program, where it will be used as a crewed lunar lander. So, that's it for today! Do you think Starship will reach orbit this year? Let us know in the comments below! And while you're at it, leave us a like and a subscription right away! Of course, as always, leave some comments with feedback and video requests below, and you might see your name popping up when it is time again for What's Next?